Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to talk about how to improve envelopes. Perhaps you have experienced it. You have created a shape and you have some text and wanted to distort the text into the shape of the envelope you created and it looks totally bonkers. So like this or even worse. What happens here? I've prepared this down here. I've drawn that shape and I've got the text. Let's first take a look at this shape. When I select the direct selection tool and click on this anchor, we see the anchor points and you see that those are really long and there are none here. It's against the rules of sorts. And when I'm selecting these, I can go to Object and then Envelope Distort, Make with Top Object. And this is what happens. And what we're seeing here is that the length of these handles determines the distortion. So that's one of the lessons we need to know. And when you think about how the handles should look like on a path, then it's like both handles need to be pulled out on a curved path segment and both of them should be around 1/3 of the length of the segment. So that's how they should be drawn and then this would look better. But it won't be perfect, actually. The next thing we could look at is this one here. So this is kind of a wave shape and we want to have it. So let's select them both and go to Object, Envelope Distort, Make with Top Object. And you see, this is what happens and it's even worse. So let's just get out of here. When you have shapes like these, you have to take into account how meshes work. An envelope is kind of a mesh, like a gradient mesh. They are the same objects. The rules that apply to gradient meshes apply to envelopes as well. I have a video about gradient meshes and please watch it in order to get to know how they work. So let's take a look at this one and I'm going to select it and let's take a look at what kind of mesh would come out of it. So I'm going to Object, Create Gradient Mesh, and then we see the lines and they look okay, actually. That's how they should look like. I'm going to cancel that. But what's not okay is this anchor point. That doesn't look right. And when we select it, you see it's a curved anchor point. Now we can try and break those handles. Press the Alt key and drag one of them and then you break them like so. And then let's take a look at this again and go to Object, Envelope Distort and Make with Top Object. And voila, that's how this should look like. And it actually looks kind of okay. The letters are straight and this is good. Now to improve this kind of shape, what we can do is take a look at the prefabricated meshes. Let's go to Object, Envelope Distort, Make with Warp. And when it's possible to use those warp options to create your envelope, you should do that because those work geometrically better than your own shapes. They're kind of perfect. So let's try and create this one. And we can go into the menu and let's take a look at arc upper, like so. You can also adjust this and you see you get different distortions when you put this into the negative value and that applies to all the other ones as well. So for instance, if you go to arc with a negative value, you can get it down there. Let's take a look at the arc upper again and bend this. And you see, it looks better than our own envelope, but still not okay. What's happening here is that these mesh lines are slanted. So that's not okay. We want them upright. And that doesn't work with Arc Upper. So let's try a different approach. We're going to cancel this. And I'm going to draw a rectangle down here, which has the same width as the text, like so. Select them both, and then let's go to Object, Envelope Distort, and Make with Warp. And we have a different one here, which is the bulge, like so. And you see, we get a nice distortion. And let's go to OK. And now what we can do is use this lower object, the rectangle, to adjust this. We can go to edit the contents and then select the rectangle with the direct selection tool, and I can move it down or up to set the center of this distortion at a different height. So the center is now, well, down here. And then we've got them both bulged. Or we can also move that up and then see that we can get a straight line below. And that can be adjusted, like so. And in order to get rid of the rectangle, of course, you can expand that and then delete it. This is how you can improve your envelopes in Adobe Illustrator. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.